Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have a super amazing sublimation tutorial. Now, this is probably one of the easiest projects you'll run across with sublimation. We are making our own glitter pattern heat transfer vinyl.
So here we are in Silhouette Studio, and I'm telling you, this is probably the easiest, or rather one of the easiest projects you will do involving sublimation and vinyl, because we are cutting glitter heat transfer vinyl, but there's no print and cut involved, there's no matching up involved, it's just a real cute and simple project. So what we're looking at here is I have set up my page, I selected my machine, which is the Cameo, cutting mat, which is also the Cameo. In my media size, I put custom, and that is because I measured the base project we're working with today, and the largest I want my design is 6.5 by 4. So I'm going to bring in an SVG file. So what I'm going to do, I just opened a file explorer window, and I will drag and drop the SVG format over into Silhouette Studio. So next I can, let's see, we can rotate this guy just a little bit and then start scaling down. Okay, so there we go. I am going to go ahead and flip horizontally. Now I'm going to click over to my send panel. That is already set to cut, so we're good there. I am going to choose, now guys, I cut my glitter heat transfer vinyl on the heat transfer flocked setting. Now that's just what works for me, so if that's not what works for you, that's okay. I also cut with a ratchet blade. So what I will do is I will go ahead and cut this from my heat transfer vinyl, and then we will reconvene and I will show you just how simple it is to finish off this project. All right, so after cutting our design, there is just one more piece that we have to do. And it's such a hardship, but I have to pick one of these gorgeous patterns to size and print. So I am actually, I pre-decided on this one right here. So I'm going to drag and drop it over into Silhouette Studio because that's where I print from. But if you don't print from Silhouette Studio, that's fine. You can do this in whatever software. Also, interestingly enough, you can do this from Infusible Ink. So even if you don't have a sublimation printer, you can still make a really cool project like this using the Infusible Ink cartridges from Cricut. So we are finished with our actual cutting design, so we can delete that. All we need is this little pattern right here. I am going to still mirror it, and I need to set my media size to letter. And because I don't like to waste paper, I'm just gonna go ahead and print two of them. I'd rather have an extra print to use later on than to let it go to waste. So now I'm going to go to print, and this is gonna bring me over into my print settings. So you can follow whatever print settings you're used to. I'm going to go through and set my paper to landscape, and select my printer, and under preferences, I'm gonna choose borderless, so it doesn't cut off the top and bottom. And then I use premium presentation paper matte and standard quality. So now I can just hit print, and this is going to send this design over to print it out on my sublimation printer.
All right, guys, let me tell you what I have here. This is the sublimation print that we just printed on our printer. This is a cotton canvas zipper bag, and this is the heat transfer vinyl, the glitter heat transfer vinyl that we just cut and weeded on our Silhouette Cameo. Now, like I said, I did do this with the Cameo, but you can do that with any brand of vinyl cutter. This is glitter, this is white glitter heat transfer vinyl, but don't forget that you can still use Easy Subly, and you can also use certain types of printable twill and flock HTV in the same method that we're going to use today. And part of the reason that this works is because this is black cotton. This is black, I guess it could technically be any material, but specifically black cotton works really, really good for this. I'm using this little zipper bag, but you can easily do this on a tote bag or a t-shirt or anything like that. So I have preheated my Cricut Easy Press. We are at 400 degrees, and I'm just going to heat press that HTV on there. Now, I just need to tack it into place so that I can remove the carrier sheet. Anytime you're pressing something with a zipper like this, you want to make sure that you have your zipper on the outside. That way you get a really good press. There we go. So that was step one, super easy. Now comes step two. Slide this underneath. Line up with our print. Now remember, in the software, I just made sure that the design, the print, was larger than the heat transfer vinyl. So just double check and make sure that the HTV is all covered up. Create your butcher paper sandwich. We still want to make sure we're getting good pressure, so make sure that that zipper is on the outside. Now I'm going to press this at 400 degrees for 60 seconds. What's going to happen is that the ink from the sublimation print is going to adhere to the glitter heat transfer vinyl. But since the rest of the project that we're working on is black, it will just look like there's nothing else there. And the reason that this works so well is just, it's just like that. The black of the bag will literally absorb any of the colors from the sublimation print or infusible ink sheet. So it's just really, really neat. It's really easy. That's really what it boils down to, is if I'm already used to cutting heat transfer vinyl and I want to whip out a cute pattern heat transfer vinyl, this is the way to do it. I don't have to worry about print and cut, and I don't have to worry about lining up anything either. All right, so just like normal, I'm going to pull this off, and this is my gorgeous new pattern glitter heat transfer vinyl using sublimation. So guys, how did you feel about our project making our own pattern glitter heat transfer vinyl? Now, I know that saying that is a little bit misleading because we're not actually printing a pattern on the glitter, but we are pressing a sublimation pattern on there. And in my book, when the final outcome looks this good, I call it a win. Now, not only is that really, really helpful for those of you doing sublimation, but the fact that you can use this with infusible ink sheets from Cricut means that you don't even have to have a printer. So it really is a very, very multi-purpose hack to use with sublimation. Now, of course, if you have any questions or comments, please make sure you leave those below. I do love to hear from you guys. And as always, make sure you subscribe to the channel, share our video with a crafty friend, even give us a thumbs up if you learned a little something today. Guys, I'm gonna wrap it up, but I do really appreciate every time you stop by and pay me a visit. I appreciate all the support that you show for the channel to help us keep bringing you these videos in the future. So thanks again, guys. I will see you again next time.